next Raw, July 25th, 2011. And the show opens immediately with the finals of the WWE Championship Tournament, The Miz and Rey Mysterio. The match was good. They didn't fuck anything up. There were no blown spots that I can remember, and they got a good amount of time to tell their stories. I was a little disappointed because I wanted The Miz to win and once again be the WWE Champion, but Rey Mysterio won the match and became the 43rd WWE Champion, winning it for the very first time. There's the new design. It's slightly thinner and has a bigger border. Otherwise, it looks exactly like the old WWE Championship. Anyway, Rey Mysterio won. And afterwards, Del Rio comes down and attempts to cash in, and he runs to the ring, and Rey Mysterio gives him the flying crossbody, knocks him on his ass, and then Del Rio grabs his case and runs away. Now, the second week in a row that Del Rio has been punked out trying to cash in his Money in the Bank briefcase. I don't know why they keep doing it like this, because all it does is make him look really weak. Why give him the briefcase at all if he's just going to get punked every time he tries to use it? Anyway, Triple H says that he will give the state of the WWE address later in the show. In the back, Rey Mysterio gets sprayed down with champagne for winning the WWE title, including some guys that I don't even think I've ever seen. I think they may have just got some guys from NXT to stand in the background, so it looks like there's a lot of baby faces there. John Cena shakes his hand, obviously, because he was the last champion before He Who Shall Not Be Named, so... Anyway, after that, we have Dolph Ziggler and Evan Bourne, and I'll say this again. Evan Bourne was still the only person at Money in the Bank who was not in the 8-man single elimination tournament for the WWE title. Dolph Ziggler was in the tournament, despite not even having a match on Money in the Bank. And Dolph Ziggler beat Evan Bourne with the sleeper. We're going back to the 80s now with our finishes, where you put the guy in a, you know, like a nerve hold or a sleeper to beat him. I don't get it. I think it's stupid, personally. Oh, and Dolph also had a slower version of his theme song. Same words and same beat, but it was slowed down. Anyway. Oh, and they have this dude who keeps showing up on Raw. He's his third appearance. The Keith Stone beer guy. Anyway, he hits on the Bellas and marks on one of the Bellas' hands so they can tell them apart. But he goes to mark them down, and then they cut. And then when they cut back, it's this huge elaborate thing on her arm. So, yeah, that was supposed to be funny, and it wasn't. Chalk that up to humor. Not liking this beginning of the Triple H regime if this is their idea of funny. Anyway. Oh, and then we have the Divas tag match. Maryse and Melina versus Kelly and Eve. Kelly pins Melina, hitting the Baymaster. So, yeah, there's that. The matches don't even matter with the Divas. They really don't. I mean, Kelly... I will say one thing. Whenever Kelly runs and hits the ring, I think, not only have I seen this before, but I think Spoonie might have mentioned this. She kind of puts her hand out so she doesn't actually have to hit the rope. I think it looks stupid. I mean, why would you... If she's so uncomfortable with hitting the rope, then don't. Food for thought. Anyway... R-Truth is talking to Triple H backstage, and you can't hear what's being said because it's one of those like wide shots where you're just supposed to see that they're talking. It doesn't really matter what they're saying. So there's that. Oh, and CeeLo Green will be performing at SummerSlam this year. You know, they had Kid Rock at WrestleMania and various other bands, and no one ever cares. It usually gets edited out of the friggin' DVDs, so why bother? I mean, I don't know. I wouldn't say I don't like CeeLo Green, but I don't see why he needs to perform at SummerSlam. But then again, I'm not the billionaire with all the genius ideas, right? So what do I know? Anyway, Triple H comes out, and he's ready to prepare to give the WWE State of the Union address. He says he's going to bring someone back to Raw, and everyone thinks he's talking about He Who Shall Not Be Named. But it turns out it's Jim Ross. He's going to put Jim Ross back on the announce table, and, I think that's the right move. Jim Ross calls a match like no one else. That guy puts so much emotion into what he says and truly believes that all the matches are the most important matches you will ever see. Does he make mistakes? Of course he does. What person doesn't? I mean, I'm sure I sound kind of monotone when I do my videos. I do try to put some emotion into it, but lately, I don't know, for some reason looking him over, I wouldn't say I lack it, but it's just kind of... I don't even know what I'm saying. I'm just kind of... Moving on. Anyway, Cole says that he doesn't want to do it. He doesn't want to work with JR because he's fat and southern and all the stuff they've been making fun of him for the last 10 years. And Triple H says that he was going to fire Michael Cole, but his compensation package is so large that it would cost way too much to just get rid of him. So Michael Cole is welcome to stay if he wants to work with Jim Ross and Jerry Lawler. He says you have until SmackDown to make your decision. In the meantime, Cole's off for the night, and he doesn't mean off completely, just off the announcement. He has to wrestle. Why? Who knows? He also says he has some gear. So Michael Cole comes out after the break, and he comes out to Triple H's theme song and his tights, and even does the water spit thing. That was kind of funny. Anyway, his opponent is Zack Ryder, who has been gaining a lot of fame over the last 8 months or so as an internet sensation guy. He's been doing a lot of online videos that have been connecting. There have even Ryder chants in various arenas, so why not? I mean, I think they're mad at him because they weren't the ones to get him over. He went and got himself over, and they don't want to push him for whatever reason. But I mean, if it works, it works. Go with it. Anyway, Ryder runs in, gives Cole the Rough Rider, and pins him. Match over. Anyway, the next match is Alberto Del Rio versus Kofi Kingston, a rematch from the tournament last week where Kingston beat Del Rio. Oh, and Ricardo Rodriguez is back. We all missed that guy. His personal ring announcer. I saw him throw a dropkick one time. That was something. Anyway, they have a match, and the match is okay, but I mean, I didn't know that Del Rio was going to win because he lost last week, and he's got the Money in the Bank, so they're planning on putting the title on him at some point, so he's got to take a win and look strong, and that's exactly what he did. Triple H states that he will be on SmackDown to give the WWE State of the WWE address, because apparently SmackDown actually matters, and they're trying to make it seem like it'll affect the entire WWE. It's a good idea. They really should have thought about making SmackDown seem important about 8 years or so ago. So yeah. And The Miz goes on a rant about how what Triple H is doing is not fair and that there will be consequences. I feel so bad for the guy. I'm sure it's not so bad, I mean, having to lose to A-Rai twice and then finally beating him in the tournament. But I mean, they couldn't find something better for the guy that headlined at WrestleMania to do, but just to rant about Triple H. Oh, and I forgot to mention, Rey Mysterio accepted a WWE Championship match from John Cena because he's a fucking idiot. A goddamn idiot. And anybody here who doesn't know what the match is next, the world title, the WWE title between John Cena and Rey Mysterio. And if you don't know who's going to win this match, then you must be new to the world of wrestling, because they have a hard-fought match, a good match to be sure, but Cena gets the FU, and he gives a big FU to everyone in the audience, and wins the title. I just don't get this. Why would they went through all this trouble to make CM Punk a huge, and I'm using his name now, fuck it, make CM Punk a huge popular sensation with the crowd and getting huge remarks everywhere they go, something different after the last 5 or so years of Cena being on top all the time, and then the second CM Punk leaves, they put the title back on Cena again. I mean, don't tell me you're going to put a brand new regime with new and interesting angles and stories and superstars if you're just going to put the belt on the same guy it wasn't before. That just makes no sense. I mean, I'm sure it's going somewhere, but I don't understand. I mean, Cena does not need to be champion. He has reached a point in his career where he's a big enough star without it that the belt can be used what it's supposed to be used for in elevating new stars. I don't know why that's such a hard point for them to grasp. Anyway, after Cena wins, Cult of Personality starts playing. It's a song. It's a good song, actually. I like it. And CM Punk comes out, getting a huge ovation. And he's holding the old WWE title. He comes down to the ring, and he holds up his belt. And Cena holds up his belt, and that's how the show goes off the air. All in all, it was a good show, but I just don't understand. Again, I don't understand why they would put the belt back on Cena. I mean, I'm sure it's going to lead to Cena versus Punk at pay-per-view and everything like that, but here's the thing. The only reason this angle is doing as good as it is because everyone thought it was like a shoot, you know, they're shooting and all that. But the problem now is it's all back to status quo. Cena's going to win. When they have the match at SummerSlam, Cena's going to beat him to avenge his loss from last month, and then all of CM Punk's momentum that he's been getting will be gone. and then we'll be back where we started. The problem with this is it should be a long-term story. CM Punk should have been gone for a month or two, or like if you needed to find a way to bring him back, have him come back and fight someone who's not John Cena. You're telling me they couldn't think of one other number one contender in the entire Raw brand, just John Cena? Anyway, that was Raw. I mean, it was a good show, but the ending pissed me off, because I really am getting sick and tired of John Cena. Anyway, guys, that's Raw. But before I go, I just wanted to make a little announcement for my 4 or 5 fans who actually watch this. In August, I'm going to try a new concept. We're going to have the... August will be the Legends of Music. That's right, I'm going to put up some small profiles on what I think are some of the biggest legends in the history of music. Some of your favorites will be on there. I'm sure you'll agree with some and disagree with others, but I wanted to pay tribute to some of my favorite artists, past and even present in some cases, and just show why they're so important to music as a whole and why I think that music as a whole is such a powerful thing for conveying messages, emotions, the whole nine. So until next time, guys, I'll catch you down the road, and I guess in August you could call me that music game. Catch you later. Snap into it.